Good morning. Today is Monday, November 16, 2020. Joint press conference of DGISPR and Foreign Minister of Pakistan. On November 14, 2020, the Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi has said that further silence on Indian provocations is not in the interest of peace in Pakistan and the region. In a joint press conference with Pakistan Army Public Relations, ISPR, Director General, DEG, Bob Arifteq, he said that today's press conference is very important since India is targeting innocent civilians on lock. The foreign minister said that the main purpose of today's press conference is to expose the real face of India. India's fascist face has been exposed to the world. Shah Mahmood Qureshi said that there are reports that India is backing state terrorism. India has prepared a plan to destabilize Pakistan and is going to turn into a rogue state. However, Pakistan would not remain silent in the name of peace if its security is compromised. He said that India has not been able to digest the significant achievements of Pakistan against terrorism. After 9/11, Pakistan paid a heavy price. 32,000 citizens were martyred and 83,000 civilians were injured in terrorist attacks in Pakistan. The foreign minister said during the press conference that terrorism caused more than $126 billion economic loss to Pakistan. He said that India was becoming a net of terrorism around Pakistan. India was using its territory against Pakistan, and we have irrefutable evidence that can be presented to the world. We are having significant details at the moment and can be presented whenever required. Shah Mahmood Qureshi said that efforts were being made to revive terrorism in Pakistan, adding that the recent terrorist attacks reflected India's grand plan. Shah Mahmood Qureshi said that Pakistan defeated TTP and BLA and other banned organizations. Today, efforts are being made to breathe new life into these banned organizations. Terrorist organizations are being funded to carry out operations in Pakistan. The foreign minister said that terrorist organizations were being asked to target clerics and security forces, adding that India intended to scale up terrorist activities in Pakistan in November and December. Watch this video with proofs to know how India is a terrorist state.
As the foreign minister has already alluded to what my part would be covering, I'll essentially be giving you the details of the evidence that we have to prove what has been already said by the foreign minister, and some of the details will also be flashed on the slides. There are some letters which are in a different language. They've been translated for ease of understanding into English for you to understand what are we referring to. And essentially I'll be giving the details of some of the evidence. The dossier has a lot more than this, but this is something, some important evidence will be flashed here. As the foreign minister has already highlighted, that India embraced all the terrorist organizations soon after they were uprooted, right? Soon after they were uprooted from Pakistan. I'll cover the details of Indian machinations of Pakistan's destabilization and economic coercion by presenting evidence of Indian funding of terrorism, weapons and equipment support to terrorists, terrorist training, and different terrorist incidents and activities that they've sponsored. The recent upsurge in the violence in Pakistan is a direct consequence of India's intensified engagements with all brands of terrorists, subnationalists, and dissidents. After unification of Tehrik-e-Taliban Pakistan with its breakaway factions Jamaat-ul-Ahrar and Hizb-ul-Ahrar, in August 2020, that organization is being shown on the screen right now, India has been endeavoring to establish a consortium of Tehrik-e-Taliban Pakistan with proscribed dissident groups of Balochistan, that is BLA, BLF, and BRA. Now, these are already united under the banner of BRAS, B-R-A-S. And this organization, BRAS, was constituted in 2018. Indian intelligence officer named Colonel Rajesh, who is employed in the Indian embassy in Afghanistan, is the master planner and the letter in Dari, which is being shown on the screen right now, it reads that he has already held 4 meetings with commanders of these terrorist organizations to synergize their efforts and execute terrorist activities in metropolitan cities of Pakistan, Karachi, Lahore, Peshawar, in November and December 2020. It has also been revealed that Indian intelligence agencies are trying to establish Pakistan's linkage with ISIS by creating Daesh-e-Pakistan. Recently, 30 Indian Daesh militants were relocated from India to various camps along Pakistan-Afghanistan border. Now, this was done by 2 Indian intelligence operatives. Their names are held with us. These militants were handed over to a Daesh commander. His name with us is Sheikh Abdul Rahim, alias Abdul Rahman Muslim Dost. Now, after highlighting some recent Indian anti-Pakistan maneuvers, now I will unfold the complete picture of Indian terrorism sponsorship by exposing the nexus of Indian intelligence agencies with terrorist organizations for their financing, training, and perpetrating terrorist activities inside Pakistan. First of all, the funding of terrorism as it goes. Uncontrivable evidence reveals that Indian embassies and consulates operating along Pakistan's borders have become hubs of terrorist sponsorship against Pakistan. We have verifiable evidence of terrorist funding by India. Now, some of that will be shared right now. Indian diplomats in Afghanistan, they have been regularly supervising various terrorist activities. In one such instance, Indian ambassador to Afghanistan and Indian consular in Jalalabad had detailed discussions with collaborators to provide financial support to Tariq-e-Taliban Pakistan and dissident Baloch elements. RAW is financing its frontmen in third countries. They have made 2 transactions to one of the cutouts to promote terrorism in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. Both transactions were made through Indian banks. $28,000 in this case were transferred by Punjab Bank in India. You can see the details on the screen. Another transaction of $55,851 was made by Mr. Manmeet, an Indian national, from an Indian bank in New Delhi and received by Afghanistan International Bank. On another occasion, RAW, while using Indian embassy in Afghanistan, held a number of meetings with TTP commanders. This letter, which is being shown on the screen, it is in Dari, it reflects that India paid $820,000 to TTP leadership through its collaborators. Now, to sabotage CPEC, India has raised a militia of 700 persons to undertake terrorism in Balochistan. A commission comprising 24 members was created, which included 10 RAW operatives. $60 million were dedicated to this force. Indian Embassy had regularly been paying handsome amounts to sub-nationalists under the garb of humanitarian assistant work projects in Balochistan. We have corroborating evidence of four such transactions in the dossier of about $23.35 million. I'll be just showing one of those transactions. It's on the screen right now, in which $5 million were given to a sub-nationalist whose name is held with us to cause unrest in Balochistan. Confessional statement of Sarfaraz Merchant and Tariq Mir revealed that Altaf Hussain Group, it was funded by RAW through two Indian companies. The names are on the screen. And evidence of transfer of $3.23 million from RAW is held with us. These are some of the details of the terrorist funding, as I said. Now I'll come over to weapons and equipment support to terrorists by India. Besides funding, India has also been rendering support to various entities through provision of weapons, ammunition, and improvised explosive devices. Recently, a RAW-sponsored network of six terrorists has been unearthed, which has linkages with attack on Pakistan Stock Exchange. That was on 29th of June 2020. And it is also involved in the delivery of suicide jackets to various terrorist groups operating in Pakistan besides undertaking terrorist activities. Two RAW frontmen, Abdul Wahid and Abdul Qadir, along with four terrorists who are Afghan nationals, have been exposed in this case. The network is also involved in target killing of ulama, police officers, and notables. RAW was paying them handsome amounts for different activities. They were paying for a suicide bombing, 10 million rupees, for a vehicle-borne IED attack, 10 million rupees, for an IED, 1 million, and 1 million for a target killing. The security forces have also intercepted huge caches of suicide jackets, IEDs, explosives, weapons, and ammunition. The details can be seen on the screen right now. Here, we also have the evidence of RAW providing weapons, ammunition, and IEDs to Tariq-e-Taliban Pakistan commanders. The letter shown on the screen right now in Dari reads that TTP leaders, after collecting the weapons, safely reached their locations after crossing the border into Pakistan. RAW agent was found involved in motivating the tribals in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa to send fighters in Afghanistan for training. The letter being reflected on the screen, it reads that RAW handler also delivered IEDs and weapons in the bordering areas of North and South Waziristan during this visit. India has also been providing weapons and ammunition to Altaf Hussain Group. Weapons worth $0.62 million were provided to Altaf Hussain Group on one such occasion. Confessional statement of Ajmal Pahadi validates this thing. Now coming over to terrorist training in India, or by India. Now I am going to present evidence of presence of multi-purpose base camps which are being utilized by India for training, harboring and launching of terrorists into Pakistan. Indian intelligence agencies are managing 87 such terrorist camps. The details are right now, they can be seen on the screen. Out of these terrorist camps, 66 are located in Afghanistan, whereas 21 are located in India. Former Indian ambassador and an Indian Army general visited Baloch militant training camp in Haji Gak area in Afghanistan. The letter in Dari, being shown on the screen, reads that the camp housed 150 militants. On another occasion, India paid $30 million to establish a camp in area of Sarhad Lawa, Kandahar, for dissidents of Balochistan. The letter you can see on the screens iterates that RAW was responsible for provision of weapons and ammunition, for which 4 helicopters were also used. Ajmal Pahari confessed in front of the Chief Justice of Pakistan that India had established 4 training camps for Altaf Hussain Group and its militants at Dehradun, Haryana, in northeast India. While the training duration varied from 15 days to 4 months, it was confirmed that 40 Altaf Hussain Group terrorists had received training in India, who used to travel to New Delhi through a third country. Some of the terrorist incidents, I'd like to give some specifics as we have the evidence now. And these investigations confirm RAW's direct involvement in these terrorist incidents. BLA and BLF, they launched attack at Pearl Continental Hotel in Gwadar on 11th of May 2019, in which 4 terrorists were killed, whereas 5 innocents were martyred. RAW officer Anurag Singh planned the attack, wherein $0.5 million were allocated by RAW for this attack. You can see some details flashed on the screen, I'll just explain them. Attacker Hamal Nawaz used an Afghan phone number and was in contact with an Indian phone number during the attack. Attack was masterminded by Dr. Allah Nazar and Aslam Achhu. Both the individuals traveled to India on fake Afghan passports. Aslam Achhu remained admitted in Indian hospital. You can see a picture of his in one of those hospitals, while he traveled under the cover name of Abdul Hamid. His passport having double entry visa stamped in India can also be seen in the picture. Dr. Allah Nazar also traveled to India on fake documents under the cover name of Haji Nabi. Dr. Allah Nazar is the main conduit between various BSNs and RAW handlers. 17 audio clips of his conversations with RAW handlers discussing future operations validate his undeniable connection with RAW. Now, an audio clip will be played in which Dr. Allah Nazar receives instructions from an officer of Indian Intelligence Agency.
Direct help to you from our side.
Okay.
Then it will be injurious to them. Then it will hamper their activities.
Okay.
They think that if AN is going to get help from India or some other place, then their primacy and their leadership will go. Right?
Okay.
So that is one problem. And second problem is people from your group, they want to take support from others by saying that AN is regressive, AN is backing the Sardars, but we would like to establish a more democratic and open society. So we are not going to stay with AN, and we will have our own group support us. So these are two different groups. They are there against you. They are opposed to each other, but they are against you. So I am afraid you may have to, stay in a different. You may have to bear the wrath of both. I find, these people may try their very best to get in. So you will have to, be very cautious, and you have to take good care of your own self.
No.
Right. And because you know your Sardar, they will never like us to help any non-Sardar.
Okay.
I think you understand that.
Yeah.
So what we will do now, that you don't try to antagonize anybody now. You stay at the course and you do your duty, whatever you are doing, and you carry forward your operation to the best of your ability. And I am trying to generate some support from private sources, if not government ones. And they will reach you very soon. And because, Dubai has become a den of ISI activity now, we would not like to conduct anything through Dubai.
Now, the investigations of attack on Agriculture University in Peshawar of 26th October 2017, it led to the masterminds of APS attack. RAW had hired three facilitators for planning the attack on Agriculture University, including Malik Faridoon, who was also involved in planning of APS attack. Malik Faridoon, soon after the APS attack, went to the Indian consulate in Jalalabad to celebrate. He also visited India for medical treatment in 2017. There he remained admitted in Primus Hospital, his name in the patient list, pictures with hospital attendant, and RAW handler Amarjeet Singh validate his connections with RAW. The attackers of Agriculture University were in contact with various Afghan numbers during the attack and live streamed the videos of to their handlers. Now, these videos were also uploaded from Afghan IP addresses. While meetings of Altaf Hussain Group with RAW's chief, Mr. Ajit Chaturvedi, and Mr. Vikram Sood were validated by Sarfraz Merchant as well as Muhammad Anwar in their statements. Recently, security forces have discovered RAW-affiliated sleeper cell in Karachi. 13 individuals of the gang have been apprehended and produced in anti-terrorist courts, whereas Mahmood Siddiqui, the main accused who was operating this network, is absconder and residing in India. Two JITs have been constituted and investigations are underway. On 11th May 2020, Peshawar police became victim of an IED attack, which resulted in injuries to two police personnel and three others. The attack was masterminded by two RAW frontmen, Noor Muhammad and Zabiullah, who were found operating from Indian consulate in Jalalabad. You can see some details on the screen. Busting of this network has averted planned future attacks on some important locations, which can be read on the screen. In June 2020, three RAW frontmen, Haji Habibullah, Haji Azizullah, and Haji Bedar, they were employed by Indian Consulate Jalalabad, tasked six Jamaat-ul-Ahrar terrorists, three Pakistanis and three Afghan nationals in Pakistan to identify important personalities for target killing. The network has remained involved in various target killings in Peshawar in the past as well and has linkages with the suicide attack of Mardan Judicial Complex in 2016. Further investigations are under progress. On 14th of August this year, Pakistan's intelligence agencies averted a massive terrorist attack planned by India. An officer from Indian intelligence agency, Major Farmin Das, which is his code name, operating from Kabul, was planning the attack. He arranged transportation of mines, rockets, and explosives, which have been recovered. The network had already carried out 7 terrorist attacks in Hub, Mastung, Quetta, and Sohrab on Ra's behest. Something about Indian interference in Azad Jammu and Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan. India is aggressively pursuing clandestine agenda of destabilizing Azad Jammu and Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan. Tangible evidence indicates that RA is involved in planting IDs in Azad Jammu and Kashmir to target civilians and military personnel. Since January 2016, 60 IEDs were planted, out of which 38 exploded, resulting into casualties of 13 civilians and 46 military personnel, whereas remaining 22 IEDs were successfully neutralized. Since January 2019, Indian intelligence handlers, having code names of Colonel Pandit and Colonel Maaz, using numbers as shown on the screen, delivered 9 IEDs to miscreants at the line of control. The forensic analysis of IEDs has confirmed use of Indian components, explosives used, the nuts and bolts, the remote used, they all lead back to being manufactured by Indian companies, as you can see the details on the screen. A video tutorial for detonating the IED was also delivered by the operative from Indian Intelligence Agency. Its video clip is being played now.
Chala gaya, chala gaya.
Haan, theek hai, dekh lo. Ye hai na, isko dabaya.
Haan, haan, ye main samajh gaya.
Haan, ye ho gaya. Uske baad ye arm aa gaya, iske upar kya karna hai, aapne dabaya.
Ji, ji.
तो इसमें आपके उसके बिल्कुल सामने होना चाहिए, मतलब आमने सामने ये है कि दूर हो लेकर वो चीज आपके सामने होनी चाहिए, जो डब्बा ना गुजरा।
जी जी भैया,
ठीक है। वो इसके नजदीक जब आएगा, सामने होगा, तो इसमें एक लिखा हुआ आ जाएगा।
जी जी,
चेक करने के लिए इधर आ गए आरडी, इधर नीचे लिखा हुआ फायर।
जी जी,
ठीक है।
हाँ हाँ, लिखा हुआ।
ये फायर दबा देना था, ये फायर दबा देना, बस ये क्या कर देगा फायर, ये अभी इसमें द्वारा लिखा हुआ फायर।
जी जी,
फायर हो गया,
समझ
गया। इतना काम है, ठीक है,
ठीक है भैया, ठीक है,
समझ गए,
समझ गया, समझ गया भैया। इसके
मैं आप लोग वीडियो बना के भेज दूंगा, इसकी कोई चक्कर नहीं, इतनी जल्दी नहीं समझ अगर आ रही तो।
राइट, there are 9 voice notes which confirm involvement of officers from Indian intelligence agencies. In what one such voice note, an Indian officer explains the method for planting an IED. Just listen to this.
सिंपल सा तरीका तुमने फॉलो करना है, जहां पहले थोड़ा सा घूम फिर लो, देख लो कौन सी जगह करना चाहते हो, जहां तुम तार, जहां चीज अंदर रखोगे, ऐसे वक्त पे जब बंदे थोड़े बाएं दाएं हों, फिर उसके ऊपर कोई बोरी शोरी रख लो, फिर तार खींच के बाहर लाओ और फिर जगह पे बैठो। तो उस जगह का तुमने एक वीडियो बना लेना है, अच्छा वीडियो बनाना है कि भाई ये जगह है। तो जितने ज़्यादा होंगे बंदे दावत में खाना खाने वाले, उतना तुम्हारा भला होगा, उसी हिसाब से तुम्हारी कीमत आगे बढ़ेगी, ठीक है। और जो वीडियो तुम बना देना, थोड़ा एक ऑडियो बता देना, ये जगह है, ये वो है, और उसका व्हाट्सएप का लोकेशन भेज देना, जिससे पता चल जाए कि ये लोकेशन क्या है। तो ऑडियो में भी थोड़ा बता देना ये जगह है, ये जैसे किसी भी जो मेल में है, या पीर चनासी में है, या मुजफ्फराबाद में है, या बाएं दाएं कहाँ पे है, जो जगह है उसके बारे में, और जो चीज़ है उसके बारे में बोल देना। फिर कार्रवाई से पहले एक आधा छोटा सा वीडियो बना लेना कि मैं पहुँच गया हूँ, मैं कार्रवाई करने वाला हूँ। तो बाकी कार्रवाई के बाद तो मुझे तो वो कार्रवाई चाहिए जिसकी खबर मुझे खबरों से सुनाई दे, टीवी से सुनाई दे, इंटरनेट से सुनाई दे, अखबारों से सुनाई दे। अगर कुछ गलत होता है तो अगर मेरे रास्ते से छूटे तो फिर किसी और के रास्ते में भी नहीं आ पाओगे, इस बात की मैं तुम्हें गारंटी दे सकता हूँ।
Raw has also been attempting to establish a network of target killing of important personalities for a reward ranging between rupees 50 to 80 million.
ये आप अपने आप देखो कि आपने हमें फिदाइन से करवाना है या वैसे कोई शूटर वूटर अगर आपके पास है तो। लाहौर का टारगेट है, बड़ा आदमी है, हाई सिक्योरिटी में होगा, अगर आपका बंदा उसको कर सकता है तो मेरी तरफ से 50 लाख आपको जो है काम होने पर मैं आपको पाकिस्तानी दे दूंगा। आप उससे पूछ लो फिर एक बार मेरे को बता दो, करना जल्दी पड़ेगा उसको।
Raw officer Brigadier Muneej, which is again his code name is MG, has transferred rupees 1.8 million to the account of an individual being motivated to undertake target killings. The money was transferred from a bank of a third country. Raw officer has been using two numbers of third countries in this case. You can see some details flashed on the screen. Coming over to Raw's destabilizing interference in Gilgit-Baltistan. India has for long been endeavoring to create unrest in Gilgit-Baltistan. In the context of provincial status for GB being discussed in Pakistan, on 28 September 2020, an important meeting was held in the Ministry of Home Affairs, New Delhi, to deliberate upon the methodology to trigger negative reactions. The salient revelations of the meeting are, Raw and IB highlighted that they are contemplating to subvert perceived changes in the status of Gilgit-Baltistan. After November 2020, hostile elements will be mobilized to undertake various subversive operations in Azad Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan. Raw aims to exploit prevalent environment by staging some terrorist attacks on large public gatherings. Assassination of a mainstream or sub-nationalist leader in Azad Jammu and Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan or a religious figure is being planned to arouse public anger. Some Indian efforts for politicization of FATF. While Pakistan remains firmly committed to the forum and our achievements for fulfilling the technical obligations remain unparalleled, India has consistently been endeavoring to politicize the forum for economic coercion of Pakistan. Tangible evidence reflects that Indian foreign missions in FATF member countries have always been extensively lobbying with hosts prior to FATF meetings to undermine Pakistan's achievements and create conditions for our gray/blacklisting. Evidence, some of the letters of these missions can be seen on the screen. It reveals that how extensive lobbying was done from between February to April 2018 for downgrading of Pakistan's status, which resulted in our grey listing in June 2018. Despite India's continuous efforts, Pakistan has come a long way, which has also been acknowledged by the international community. On the contrary, it is India which needs to be scrutinized at FATF platform in the light of evidence presented by Pakistan, as well as recent revelations made by FinCEN, revealing Indian terror financing and money laundering regimes. In the end, I will just once again reiterate before I hand over to the Honorable Foreign Minister.
DGISPR said that Indian embassies in Afghanistan were funding Baloch factions. The mastermind of the terrorist attack on PC Gwadar was RAW officer Anurag Singh. India had invested $30 million for a terrorist camp in Kandahar. Major General Babar Iftikhar said that Malik Feridun also had links with Indian intelligence agency. After APS Peshawar attack, Malik Feridun went to Indian consulate in Afghanistan. India is conspiring to destabilize Azad Kashmir, Gilgit Baltistan. He said that due to the efforts of Pakistani intelligence agencies, several conspiracies of terrorism had failed. Indian forces had targeted unarmed Kashmirs yesterday. India was inciting anti-Pakistan forces by uniting. Thanks for watching Newstime 9. If you like this video, please subscribe the channel, like and share this video.